Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Nimisha Jadhav from School of Studies in Environmental Chemistry, Jivaji University, Gwalior. Today we are going to discuss about the module Bacteriological Determination of Water under the paper of Environmental Analysis. The learning objective of this module including the indicator information about the indicator microorganism. We will also discuss about the composition of common bacteriological cultural media, then the various types of techniques used for the determination of total MPN, then the fecal coliform and the salmonella present in the wastewater or the drinking water sample. First of all, here we have discussed about the microbiological analysis. Why we require microbiological analysis? Because the various waterborne pathogens can enter into the human body through the impact of compromising skin, inhalation, ingestion, aspiration, or by the direct contact with the mucosa of the eyes, ear, nose, mouth, and genital, and they causes various types of diseases. Max of the diseases in human body is mediated by using the contaminated water with the pathogens. A risk analysis approach is required for overcoming the problem with waterborne diseases and the water quality monitoring. The methods for the detection of many pathogens are not yet available for the setting standards for microbial contamination and could be proved difficult because of the reason that days to weeks are sometimes required to obtain the result. And the second important factor is the expensive and the time consuming methods are often required to detect and the quantify the presence of specific pathogen. It is also difficult to overcome these difficulties, and the concept of testing water sample for indicator organisms are introduced as far back as the turn of the 19th century. The concept was developed for assessing fecal contamination of the water. The detection of these bacteria would essentially mean that the fecal contamination has occurred. First of all, we have discussed here about the criteria for the indicator microorganism in the water. The number one criteria is it should be useful for all types of water. The next important criteria is it should be present whenever enteric pathogens are present. Then the third one is it should have a reasonable longer survival time than the hardest entering pathogen. Then it should not grow in the water. Next is the testing method for the organism should be easy to perform. Then the density of the indicator should have some direct relationship to the degree of the fecal pollution. It should be a member of the intestinal microflora of humans as well as is the warm-blooded animals. Now we discuss here about the indicator microorganisms. Number one indicator microorganism is a very well-known coliform bacteria. The coliform bacteria included all aerobic, facultative, and anaerobic bacteria. The deficiencies with the use of coliform bacteria as indicator of water quality include regrowth in aquatic environments and regrowth in distribution systems. The deficiencies with the use of coliform bacteria as indicator of water quality included suppression by high background bacterial growth. It is not indicative of the health threat and there is no relationship with enteric protozoa and viral concentration. The coliform bacteria had been used to assess the microbial quality of drinking water. A new approach was needed to ensure that the microbial safety of drinking water. The most probable number, that is denoted by MPN, the membrane filter, which is denoted by MF, and the pressure absence P by A test are used to detect the total coliform present in the water. Now we discuss here about the fecal coliform bacteria. The fecal coliform bacteria are differentiated by their ability to ferment lactose with the production of acid and gas, and at 44.5 degrees centigrade within the 24 hours. The fecal streptococci, for example, S. bovine and S. equinis, and have certain advantages over the coliform as indicator. Here you have seen the picture of this fecal streptococci bacteria. These types of bacteria are rarely multiply in the water. They are more resistant to the environmental stress. They are persist longer in the environment, and they suggested as a useful indicator for the recreational water. So both most probable number method and the membrane filter method may be used for the isolation of this fecal bacteria. The major fecal bacteria including the Clostridium perfringens, then Pseudomonas aeruginosa, then hydrogen sulfide producing bacteria, and the coliphages and other bacteriophages. Now we discuss about the composition of common bacteriological cultural media. There are various types of culture media used to identify the microbial growth in the water sample. Number one and the most commonly used medium is the MAC Conkey broth solution. It is again classified as double strength medium or the single strength medium. The double strength medium is prepared by dissolving the peptone, sodium chloride and bile salts in water by heating and store at 4 degrees centigrade. And the single strength medium is prepared by diluting the double strength medium with an equal volume of distilled water. The next culture media is known as brilliant green lactose bile broth. Then the next one is the EC broth medium. Then EC mug medium. And the last one is the MAC Conkey agar medium, is most widely used culture media for growing the identifying the microbial culture in the water sample. We are discussing here about the brilliant green lactose bile broth. In this medium, we are preparing it by dissolving peptone and lactose in 500 ml of distilled water, and after that add 20 g of dehydrated oxgol dissolved in 200 ml of distilled water. The pH of this solution should be 7 to 7.5. Mix, hold the sample and add water to make 975 brilliant green in distilled water. Then add distilled water to make up to an 1 liter. After that, dispense into fermentation tube, making certain that the fluid level covers inverted vials. Then it is autoclaved for 15 minutes at 121 degrees centigrade, and final pH is maintained between 7.2 plus minus 0.1. The next medium is the EC broth medium. It is distribute 8 ml portion to 16 into 150 millimeter test tube containing inverted fermentation in Durham tubes, and then autoclave 15 minutes at 121 degrees centigrade. Final pH maintained at 6.9 plus minus 0.2. The next one medium is known as EC mug medium. It is prepared as for EC broth above, but at 50 mg methylum bellifiral beta D glucuronide, which is also known as MUG, per liter before autoclaving for 15 minutes at 121 degrees centigrade. Do not use Durham tubes as gas is not relevant to the test and could interfere with the interpretation of the UV light results. The next medium is the MAC Conkey agar. It is a crystal white and NaCl by weight of sodium tetrachloride. It is a mixture of these two chemicals. Then the suspended ingredients and Shear with the agitation to dissolve. After that, boil for 1 to 2 minutes and autoclave for 15 minutes at 121 degree centigrade. Then the solution is cooled down 45 to 50 degree centigrade and pour 20 ml portion into sterile 15 into 100 mm petri dishes. Then it is dry at room temperature with closed lids. Final pH attained is the 7.1 plus minus 0.2. Now we discuss about the methods of testing fecal coliform bacteria. In the laboratory, there are three simple procedures of testing water samples for fecal contamination. Number one is the hydrogen sulfide strip method. It is a simple, reliable, and easy to perform method. Pressure and absence test for bacteriological quality is carried out in the same way. It is works on the principle that there is a close correlation between the fecal contamination and the pressure of hydrogen sulfide producing bacteria. Most probable number method for coliform bacteria using the multiple tube fermentation technique. In this method, the MPN, the most probable number of total coliform bacteria, fecal coliform bacteria present in the water is calculated. The sample is determined along with the pressure or absence of Escherichia coli. Here we are discussing about the multiple tube fermentation technique for the coliform bacteria. It is also known as MPN test, that is most probable number test. In the multiple tube method, a series of tube containing a suitable selective broth culture medium like lactose containing broth such as McConkey broth is inoculated with test portion of the water sample. After a specified incubation time at a given temperature, each tube showing gas formation is regarded as presumptive positive. The two tests are known respectively as the presumptive test and the confirmatory test. For the confirmatory test, a more selective culture medium like Brilliant Green bile broth is inoculated with the material taken from the positive tubes. After an appropriate incubation time, the tubes are examined for gas formation as before. The most probable number of bacteria present can then be estimated from the number of tubes inoculated and the number of positive tubes obtained in the confirmatory test. Using specially devised statistical tables are prepared, and this technique is known as the MPN method. Now we'll discuss about the determination of MPN. For treated water, where 150 ml, 510 ml and the 51 ml portions are inoculated, the MPN can be found from the test results by referring to the MPN table. It is also known as McCready table. It would be best to use the numbers from the confirmatory test for the determination of water quality. Here in this table, we identify the water samples are classified based on the presumptive count in the following way. In the first section, we can discuss about the class, then the grading, then coliform count per 100 ml of MPN and the E. coli count per 100 ml. For the class 1, we are giving the grading is excellent and the coliform count is calculated as 10 per 100 ml of MPN and E. coli count is 0. Then the second class is grading given is satisfactory and the coliform count calculated between to 1 to 3 per 100 ml of MPN and the E. coli count is 0. In the class 3, the grading is suspicious but the coliform count lies in between the 4 to 10 per 100 ml of MPN and the E. coli count per 100 ml is 0. And the class 4, the grading is unsatisfactory and the coliform count is greater than 10 but the E. coli count is 0 or more. Now we discuss about the membrane, another one method of bacterial determination, that is membrane filtration method for total coliform and the thermotolerant fecal coliforms. The method is based on the filtration of a known volume of water through a membrane filter. The bacteria are retained on the surface of the membrane filter. When the membrane containing the bacteria is incubated, characteristic colonies of coliforms or thermotolerant coliforms develop, which can be counted directly. In contrast to the multiple tube method, the membrane filtration method gives as a direct count of total coliform and the thermotolerant coliforms. A comparison of the two methods, namely the multiple tube method and the membrane filtration method, depicting the relative advantage. The factor affecting this technique including the volume of water sample for filtration, microbes, overpopulation and types of water samples. In this table, we have discussed about the typical volume for membrane filtration method. First, we have taken the sample type and then the sample volume. For the treated drinking water, the volume sample volume required for the membrane filtration method is 100 ml. For the partially treated drinking water, the sample volume required 10 to 100 ml for the membrane filtration method. And for the protected source water or the ground water, the sample volume required is in between the 10 to 100 ml. And for the surface water and the water from the open wells, again need 0.1 to 100 ml of sample volume for the detection of membrane filtration method. The next technique is the EC mug test for confirmation of E. coli. This is a simple test for confirmation of presence of E. coli in water samples and may be knitted into the multiple tube fermentation procedure. The medium used will be BGLB and tryptophan broth, that is also known as indole test, at 44.5 degree centigrade. The EC mug method test is used for the presence of E. coli bacteria. The mug stands for 4-methylamble ferryl beta D glucuronide. It is the substrate for the enzyme beta glucuronidase. This enzyme is primarily found only in E. coli, so that this method is particularly used for the presence of E. coli bacteria. The enzyme cleaves the mug molecule. The media or the equipment needed for this procedure is the EC mug medium, then water bath and the long wave UV lamp. The procedure included that the EC mug broth tubes are inoculated from positive presumptive McConkie broth tubes or oblique bottles, and the inoculated tubes are incubated at 44.5 degree centigrade for 24 hours. A positive reaction is observance of a bright blue fluorescence when the tube is subjected to long wave, that is 366 nanometer ultraviolet light. The use of positive, a known E. coli mug positive culture, and the negative, that is thermotolerant Klebsiella pneumonia mug negative, control reaction is highly recommended. An uninoculated medium control may also be necessary to interpret the result and to avoid confusion of weak autofluorescence of the medium as a positive response. The interferences of bacteriological determination included the certain brands of glass test tube and fluorescences under the UV light. So they are interfering in the determination of microbiological growth. Then the tube should not be examined before use, so that microbiological growth can be hindered by using this. And the Durham tubes are not suitable for identifying the microbial determination of the water sample. Here we have discussed about the detection of Salmonella. The Salmonella are ग्राम निगेटिव, ऑक्सीडेज निगेटिव, नॉन स्पोर फॉर्मिंग रोड शेप्ड बैक्टीरिया विच इज एबल टू फर्मेंट ग्लूकोज एंड कैपेबल ऑफ फैकल्टेटिव एनारोबिक ग्रोथ. द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द डिटेक्शन ऑफ साल्मोनेला इज डिस्कस हेयर. The detection of Salmonella is based on pre-enrichment, selective enrichment, followed by isolation on selective media. Presumptive Salmonella colonies are confirmed by biochemical and serological tests. Pre-enrichment broth is necessary to enable injured cells to grow. Further, selective enrichment is done to increase the proportion of Salmonella in relation to background flora. Selective media are used for further isolation and preliminary confirmation. Now we discuss about the culture media used for the detection of Salmonella. For that we are using buffered Pepton water, then Wrap apart vaselinitis broth, that is also known as RVS broth, then brilliant green or phenol red lactose agar, that is known as BGA, then xylose lysine deoxychloate agar, that is known as XLD, bismuth sulfide agar, that is used optionally, and the nutrient agar. Now we come to the procedure. In the procedure, the first one technique is the pre-enrichment. A septically clean and surface of bottle, pouch, cups containing sample with 70% ethanol and filter 250 ml or as specified of water sample through a membrane filter of 0.45 micrometer pore size using sterile membrane filtration assembly. Place the filter disc in 50 ml buffered Pepton water and incubate at 36 plus minus 2 degree centigrade for 16 to 20 hours. The second one is the selective enrichment. For that, transfer 0.1 ml of the pre-enrichment culture to 10 ml or 1 ml to 100 ml of malachite green or the magnesium chloride, that is modified RVS broth, and incubate at 42 plus minus 0.5 degree centigrade for 18 to 24 hours. Confirmation on selective agar media. After incubation, streak a loop full from RVS broth on selective medium, that is BGA, XLD and the BS, that is optional. Incubate the plates at 36 plus minus 2 degree centigrade for 24 hours and 48 hours for BSA. In order to detect slow growing Salmonella, inoculate BGA, XLD and BSA after continued incubation of RVS broth for further 24 hours. Now we come to the part of observation. The colonies on BGA are red or slightly pink white and opaque with the red surrounding. The colonies on XLD agar are colorless but appear red usually with a black center. On BSA medium, black colonies appear surrounded by a metallic sheen. The Salmonella hydrogen sulfide negative strands appear on XLD agar as pink with a darker pink center. The lactose positive Salmonella strands grow on XLD agar as yellow with or without blackening. The confirmation is done if there are the typical or suspected colonies, the plate at least one selected colony from each positive agar medium and further 4 colonies if the first colony tests negative on nutrient agar plates and incubate at 36 degrees centigrade plus minus 2 degrees centigrade for 18 to 24 hours and thereafter proceed for further biochemical and serological confirmation. Now the next is the biochemical confirmation. For that, lactose glucose fermentation and the hydrogen sulfide formation is used for the biochemical confirmation. In this technique, streak a colony on iron or 2 sugar agar that is known as Kligner iron agar slant and the stab the butt. The incubate at 36 plus minus 2 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. Typical salmonella shows red slant with gas formation and yellow butts with blackening of agar. Under degradation, incubate a colonial slant of urea agar and incubate at 36 plus minus 2 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. The typical salmonella culture show a negative reaction, that is no rose pink color followed by deep caries. So at the end of this module, we can conclude it that in this module we have learned about the different types of microorganism that causes waterborne diseases. We also discuss the techniques of determining the coliform bacteria and the fecal coliform bacteria by two methods. The number one is membrane filtration method and second one is MPM, that is most probable number method. Here we also discuss the determination of salmonella in a water sample in detail, and we have also discussed the various types of medium used for the growth of microorganism like single strength or double strength MAC concave broth solution, then EC muck solution, MAC concave agar solution, EC muck green bile broth solution. So these are the various types of medium which are used for the development of these microorganisms or for the identification of such kind of microorganism in the wastewater sample. We have also studied here the various interferences which are interfere or hindered the analysis of these microorganisms, and included the various steps to remove such kind of interferences of analysis of microorganism. Thank you so much.